their position and their form, looking at your position and the form that you've been in recently, would you look at this as a game that you might earmark for 3 points?
No, you look at it no different to any other game. We're there, of course, to win the 3 points. Focus on trying to win the 3 points. Hull will be doing the same, but yeah, we're in good form at the moment, but form can change very quickly as well, so we're mindful of that. But it's really just trying to push on with our own agenda, focus on ourselves, respect the strengths that Hull have, and but really focus on ourselves, try and put a good performance on to try and get those 3 points.
What are their strengths?
Well, of course, it's been a difficult season. It's always a difficult season in the Premier League, but you know, they have good players, good experience, they have good quality within their group. I watched their game against Chelsea. I thought they were unlucky, actually, to be fair, in that game. I thought they performed extremely well. And no, they'd be tough. We've always had good games with Hull, always close encounters, and always a tough physical game with them. But like I said, they have got quality to be able to hurt us if we're not on our game. But if we're on point and we're ready and our attitude is spot on, our football is good enough, then I'm sure that we can come away with 3 points. But we realise how difficult that is.
And the fact that they are in a battle near the bottom, does that make them more dangerous than, say, another mid-table team?
Well, this is it. This is the business end of the season. Everyone's fighting for their own reasons, different reasons. Hull have got there. Obviously, they want to steer clear of that relegation zone. So they'll be very determined, a very determined side coming down here. And like I said, they have got quality as well. So we have to be very prepared and ready for that. But judging by the week that we had, we seem very focused, and like I said, we've got our own agenda that we're trying to achieve, and hopefully we can put that focus and drive into our game, our performance in front of our crowd on our home patch, where we lost our last game here. So we want to put that right and try and get another win.
And against the teams that are currently in the bottom seven at home, you've not lost to any of them. Is that encouraging as well when you look at Hull coming?
Well, it'd be nice if that stays the same, for sure. That's always the aim. But I don't look at it like that. We don't split the teams up where they are in the leagues, and this is what you aim for. I said it many times before, I've really just make the players focus on the week that we have, the team that we're playing that week, really just put all focus on that, not look too far ahead, not look too far in the past, and that's what we've been doing this week. It's all been preparation for Hull against a Hull side, and prepare for the best Hull side that we can, and make sure that we're focused for that.
How many players did you have on international duty this week?
Good question. Quite a few. But
the reason I ask is that the stats show that after an international game, it's been three occasions this season, you haven't won the first match.
Well, we have to put that right on Saturday. But no, it's, of course, you try and, it's never easy, international breaks. It does disrupt your preparations, because a lot of them come back later on in, like, for instance, this week is, you know, you get probably 2 to 3 days preparation with them, but obviously the rest of the group are preparing a lot longer than that. But these are the decisions you have to make. You assess them when they come back, see how they are physically, mentally, and how well they did in those games, and make sure that there's nothing from that, and then you select the side from there. But I think we've been a bit unlucky in some of those games. So statistics, I don't really read into them from there. But of course, we'd like to come out Saturday after an international break and get a win.
It's the problem with being a big club, isn't it?
Yeah, that's why you need the squad now. That's why you need bigger squads nowadays with quality. And it's a tough regime, especially for those international players. There's no break throughout the season. Some players that don't go away on international will be able to get a good rest period within that 2 week period where you haven't got a game. But for the internationals, it's constant. You know, it's constant all the way through. And some of them are playing 60, 70 games a season. To ask the demands that you're asking of them every single day, and as well as the matches, it's a lot. But that's where our physical preparation and everything that we put into training to condition the players is that they're able to do that.
I would think after their result in Israel, Ashley and Neil Taylor will be absolutely bouncing, won't they?
Well, yeah, hopefully. It's a good, nice, confident win there. And I thought they, tremendous performance. And from them too as well. I thought they were really controlled and performed really well. And they've been doing that now for Swansea this season. They took it into the international stage. It's about bringing that back. Like you said, a good, nice, confident win there and putting that into their game for Saturday.
Does that help you as well, the fact that the international boys, wherever they go, do well and come? Do they bring that back to the squad with them?
Well, of course it's separate. Of course it's different environment and a different, whole different feeling with international and club games. But yeah, you do want them to go well. You don't want them to go away and be poor and perform poor and bring back any negativity at all. Like, so no, but I think generally all the international breaks that we've had, the players that have gone away have done very well in their international games, and the biggest part is avoiding injuries, which can happen. But no, I think all of them have done very well for their countries, and they're obviously proud to represent their countries, and obviously it elevates your game, elevates your status, and you come back, you feel a more important player, and obviously when you're playing for your club and your country, it's obviously important like that.
We're getting towards the end of the season, and obviously it's beginning to people are beginning to look now at possible transfers in the summer. So here's
who have you got for me, Raj?
I've got Fabianski to Roma.
Oh, hi, okay. Holiday or
no? For a no. Transfer, apparently.
Okay.
No holiday.
No holiday for him. Look, it's what it is, isn't it? We've always been linked with players away. It's credit to Fabi's performances this season. They've been exceptional. Whether there's any concrete behind those sort of rumours, it's always the way, but Fab's very focused on Swansea, and I know that he's put his own comments out how focused he is, and I'm not looking to push any players out. You know, I want to build on the quality that I already have, add quality, not take away quality, and that's what we'd be looking to do this summer.
So presumably you would say to Tony Pulis at West Brom, you're not having Neil Taylor either?
Yeah, no. I want to keep all the quality players that we have at the club, and like I said, only add to them. It's an important season for us to finish the season as strong as possible, put that way of working into him this season, and next season it's probably one of the biggest in the club's history in terms of if you look at the rewards for next season with all the new TV rights and the money that the club can gain from that season, it's massive that we don't lose any quality in the summer and that we only add to it, which is why it's so important for the club and for us for next season.
And Neil's only got a year left. Are you starting to talk to him about an extension?
Yeah, he's in negotiations. Obviously, I'll leave that side of it to the club and his representatives. With Neil, it's just focus on his football. And I think, you know, especially in recent months, his performance levels have gone up and a good confidence in his game. And I've enjoyed watching him and working with him. And for me, as I've said to Neil, it's just focus on your football. And that side of it, you leave to your representatives. You leave to the club side of it to negotiate and concentrate on that side of it. The rest of it for myself is to manage him properly and for him to worry about his football, and that's what Neil's doing.
And somebody that you've been linked with to bring in is the Dutchman, Bas Dost. What was the report?
You nearly swore there. Huh?
what was the report? Because apparently you had him watched playing for the international the other week.
It's news to me, but of course we've always got scouts, you know, watching in different countries, watching here, home, you know, in Britain, watching abroad. We always have scouts of games, but every club has that. So whether he was at a game where that player was playing, I don't know. You know, you have to speak to the scouting network. But of course, we identify all different targets. You're constantly watching players. Names will always crop up. But, you know, it's about us keeping that close to our chest. And we always do it that way, watch a number of different players, but then shortlist it. And that's what will be happening, I'm sure, in the coming month or so, is shortlist those players and then have a proper look at them and then make a targets for the summer.
You're not going to tell me if he's on your shortlist then?
No, he's obviously that name has not come up in my meetings that I've had with the recruitment side of it and with my scouting network, but that's not to say that there hasn't been a Swansea scout at one of them games. It might not be to watch that particular player, but he might be at those type of games. So we have scouts across Europe, so they're obviously watching a lot of games, and you could probably link any player on that day, you know, if you want to make a story. But no, we have our own targets and we're trying to shortlist them and then see if they're available, affordable, and we'll go from there.
You mentioned about having the strength in depth now in the squad, and you're going to need that now because obviously there's the injury to Tom Carroll.
Mm.
What's the situation with Tom? Is he going to go back? Is he likely to play again this season?
I'm just disappointed really for Tom. He obviously gone away on international duty, and it's always difficult when they get injured. He obviously played well. He scored the goal, and I think it was actually from the goal that he got injured. So he's been... That injury that he has, which is, you know, just above his, well, just around his ankle and top of his foot, is he's had it for a few weeks, but he's played with it, he's managed it, obviously he tweaked it just a little bit more in that game, so disappointing. But no, obviously we have to assess it really over the coming week or so, 2 weeks, whether it's a long term or, you know, in terms of long term, I mean, you know, if it's 4, 8 weeks, six weeks, 12 weeks, whatever it is, or if it's just a couple of weeks, you know. But no, we're looking for Tom to be back involved, you know, before the end of the season. And, you know, he's young enough to recover well, and it's not a serious injury. It's just one that needs to manage and get him back to where it's comfortable, and hopefully he'll be back with the group as soon as he can.
Have you seen enough of him to know whether you can or want to sign him?
I think Tom's done tremendous. It's been difficult as well because, you know, he's played some good games. He you know, it's always difficult when, you know, you have your, the midfielders that he's competing with. Every player wants to play 30, 40 games a season. It, you know, Tom's still young, but he's ambitious. He wants to be playing those 30, 40 games. But for him this season, it's been more difficult. But what he's contributed, I thought he's done very well. Whether we take him in the summer, obviously I'll sit down with Tom. We'll assess that towards the end of the season, his contribution and how I'm planning for the summer. And if it fits and we both feel it's the right thing to do going forward, then obviously I'll have that discussion, but we haven't quite had that yet.
Spurs likely to let him go? I mean, they might say no, we don't want to sell him.
That's what I mean. We haven't had those discussions with Tottenham, with Tom himself, those, you know, those final discussions on the future going forward. So I just wanted to let the players concentrate on their football. I don't want to bombard them with other thoughts other than that, because we've still got a job to do. So it's all focused on the football now, and I'm sure towards the end of the season, with the last few games to go, that we can sit down with, you know, a few of the players and assess it from there. And Tom is obviously one of them, where we'll make that proper, you know, situation, whether we keep him or going, or how he feels, how I feel, how the club feels, how Tottenham feels, how Swansea feels, and then come up to with the right answer.
Montero's out as well, I think, isn't he?
Saturday. Well, he come back today, and it's not as serious as the reports have said. So we had an assessment today. Really, we make a proper assessment tomorrow, whether he's available for the weekend. But it's not as serious as first feared. But yeah, today obviously Key come back as well, so they were more on recovery days anyway. That was the plan all along. Obviously they got the detail from training that we had today, but we'll make a proper assessment on Jefferson tomorrow.
And anybody else? Can Leon fit again? Kyle Bartley fit again?
Yep, Leon and Kyle joined back with the group this week, so they're fit, back in the squad and available for selection.
If I can ask you one on a wider subject, Greg Dyke has said that he wants to increase the number of homegrown players now in the 25. He wants to lift it to 12. Your thoughts on that?
It's an interesting subject, because it's such a global sport, football now, and people want to see the best player, especially in the Premier League. I think they just want to see the best. So for me, it's more quality than quantity. If we can help the homegrown players, and I think we do a lot of this club, I think if you look at the academy that we have, I think it's 90% are all Welsh, you know. And if you look at the team that we have, the squad that I have in the first team, there's a lot of homegrown players within that. But I think the focus, we have to be very careful that it's not just quantity, you know, because at the end of the day, they have to be good enough. And I think it all stems back to the coaching that these kids get growing up, where they're at, what environment they're in, and how good they are, you know, technically and physically and, you know, tactically and mentally, and that comes down to the coaching. It's the most important part of their growing up. So I'm not against it, but there are pros and cons to it, you know. It's not just making sure that we up the numbers just purely because it sounds good, you know. The quality has to be as good as what we have it right now. So but I do think it's a global sport. We want to see players not just from Britain, but we want to see players from all around the world, because everyone has something to offer. So I think there is things you can do, but whether it's exactly that, I'm not so sure.
Gary, was it just Tom and Jefferson that came back from international duty struggling? Is everyone else okay?
Yeah, everyone else is fine. Jefferson, like we said, we have to really assess him properly tomorrow. You know, he's a little bit sore. But, you know, Jefferson's a tough lad. He's always eager to play and be involved. So we'll see, make a final assessment on him tomorrow in training, and then see whether he's ready, if it's too soon in the weekend, or if he's okay, you know. You never know, but that 24 hours will do him the world of good. Tom, obviously disappointed, really, because he's contributed really well to the squad. But again, we're unaware right now. We have to see how it settles down over the coming 7 days or so, and it could be more short-term than long-term, but hopefully getting Tom back in with the group before, you know, way before the end of the season.
You talk about affordability. You obviously banked a lot of money for Wilfred Bony in January. Is there a danger that clubs will know that you've got burn in your pocket, but clubs will know that's available and may add a few digits on, shall we say.
Well, I said it at the time, I think when we sold Wilfred for that amount of money, everyone thought that's instantly what you've got to spend on other players. Of course we need to strengthen the squad, but I just talked about it there, the academy, the first team training ground, the stadium expansion, all these type of things cost money. And obviously I'm well aware that the club need to, you know, money doesn't grow on trees, so a lot of that money and stuff like that will go on the infrastructure at the club and trying to improve the infrastructure. But of course I'll be naive to not think or to say that we're not focusing on bringing players in, and of course there has to be a pot of money for us to be able to do. But as always with the club, it's is doing it where it's affordable. It's not spending stupid money or unbelievable money on players that we can get for cheaper prices. So it's always within the budget, always within what the club constraints are, and that's how I have to work as a manager.
And do you know your budget yet for the summer?
No, the relationship I have and the way I go forward with it is obviously it's a discussion with the chairman on that particular player, and if we can afford it, we'll do it. If it's unaffordable, which I think you've seen from some of the transfer windows that we've already had, if we feel that the player isn't worth that or they're asking too much money, we won't do the deal. It's as simple as that. It has to be affordable to what we think's realistic, to what we're looking for.
Because that's something the club has done, not just recently, but for a number of years. They've never lived beyond their means, and that's probably why you're in the position you're in now compared to where you were.
And I don't think that'll ever change. I think it's good. Of course, there's sometimes when you're pushing for that last little bit and it doesn't quite happen, but this is part of management. You have to work within constraints and use your restraints well and try and work within it and be clever with it, and that's what we try and do. And that can be through transfers, permanents, loans, whatever you want to do. So, or you're trying to bring the kids through and use another young lad or whatever it is, that's what we have to look for and be clever with, myself as a manager and obviously the club as a whole.
You've talked about not losing the quality you've got here. You're obviously talking to Neil. I'm just wondering, are you talking to anyone else about a new contract at the moment?
It's always ongoing. There's always players. I think the club have learned over the years to try and not let players get into their last year of their contracts, because that's when the player holds all the cards, and a lot of the time from the investment the club's put in and the time that the club's put in, it's always a kick in the teeth when players run down their contracts. You can't always stop it. It will happen. It happens at every club, but the club are always constantly in negotiations and foreseeing in front of what players are coming to what in their contracts, whether they're staying or going, and what do we do. But we're always on top of that, and obviously that I leave that negotiation side of it to the chairman and to the board to negotiate those contracts.
So you're not aware of certain individuals right now who are in Neil's boat?
No, Neil's obviously the situation he was in, but like I said, it's ongoing. Negotiations don't just happen overnight. It's up to his representatives and the club to discuss those, and Neil focus on his football, me focus with him on his football, and get the best out of him, which he's doing right now.